The sins of the fathers. One thing my father always told me. He said, son, you can change everything there is about a man, except his heart. Especially if that heart is weak. And I'm not talking about a regular weakness. God knows. I have my fair share of those. Shit. We all do. Those weaknesses are harmless enough. Harmless to others, anyhow. How they affect you? Well, that's your own choice. But the one I'm talking about is different. This one is like a stain in the very depths of your soul. It waits patiently to expose itself at just the right moment. A darkness that, if given even one breath of life, could quickly grow beyond the limits of your control. Those with a strong heart may have a slight chance against it. Those with a weak heart. Weakness is beyond their control. It must be. What else would make a person knowingly harm someone so defenseless? In animals, if a mother senses that kind of weakness in her newborn, she'll leave it behind to die. It's a natural instinct. But in humans, that instinct goes against moral law. All you can do is show a person the way. If their heart won't let them take it, then it's out of your control. But in the end, where do you place the blame? The heart for being weak? Or the man himself for succumbing? That kind of weakness is like a double-edged sword. Face it head on, see it coming, and you just might have a chance to defend yourself against it. Then again, maybe not. But turn your back to it. And pretend the weakness doesn't exist. The results are guaranteed to be deadly. Sins of the fathers. The fathers shall not be put to death for their children. Neither shall the children be put to death for the fathers. Every man shall be put to death for his own sins.